Welcome, Aaron.
How you doing?
Yeah, good.
Yourself? Yeah, good, thanks.
Just calm your farm, mate.
So we'd like to welcome our first official guest on Unhinged program. We have Aaron from Dillytek. How would you rate this in your list of accomplishments?
I think it's pretty special. Like, this is your first show and you've asked us to be a part of it, so myself to be a part of it, so it's thank you guys.
It's probably got nothing on. I was like, DEFCON Netherlands, nothing on. Nah. But like, Unhinged first show.
Oh, this is our first live stream, so.
Is it really?
Yeah, we've never done a live stream before.
Too gangster. Wow. Hey, can you just pull that microphone just a little closer
to
you?
Yeah. Sweet. Yeah, so ticking boxes.
Yeah. Before we get into the serious questions, I've got to ask, what's it like being best friends with basically a bandmate with someone else whose name is Aaron?
Well, straight up, it's like pretty cool having your mate like there next to you, being able to share those experiences and those goals and accomplishments. But no, it's always definitely a novelty when we introduce ourselves to somebody. It's like,
I'm Aaron.
Actually, I remember first time that we introduced ourselves to Toby Matrix.
Yep.
Yeah, he found it pretty uncanny.
Because my name's Caleb, obviously, so I don't get to meet a lot of other Calebs.
Really?
So if, and like, the few times that I do, it's like a really big deal. And I'm like, hey, I'm Caleb. And they're like, oh, I'm Caleb.
Joe.
I'm like, oh my God, we're both named Caleb. What do you call each other?
Gracie.
Yep.
Last name Grace. And Tilsy. Last name Tills.
Well, that makes a lot of sense, I guess.
Yeah.
So on the weekend, you played at Massive and you played right after Frontliner. You've listed him as Dillytek's early inspiration, yep. Of one of Dillytek's early inspirations. What's it like to support someone who you once had as an inspiration?
Well, he still is an inspiration. So, and it's amazing. Like, you know, we've had the opportunity to play quite after and before quite a few international DJs, and like, it doesn't get any less effective on us, so to say. So no, it's definitely always a real honor and makes it pretty special. I think.
I want to ask the people watching at home, if you've got a question for Aaron, by the way, feel free to pop them in the comment section, and my learned friend here, Luke, will keep an eye on what you guys write, and if anything good comes out, we'll ask Aaron and put him on the spot a little bit.
Steve Hill wants to know how many Nurofen you can hide in your beard.
100. No more, no less.
It has to be 100. Nurofen. Not Panadol. You guys wrote a track with Frontliner called Elevate back in 2014. That was actually released on Q-Dance Records. Like, tell us how that came about and the whole process behind it.
Yeah, that's going back a little bit. Well, I'm pretty sure what it was is he was coming over to tour, and I think Wasted Penguins were also on that tour as well. Q-Dance asked us to come along and be a part of that tour, and as a way to promote it, they lined up a few collabs between some of the guys that were on the tour and some of the international guys that were coming along, and we were one of the lucky ones that got to be a part of that. So
yeah, that would have been a good little learning experience too, I'd imagine.
Not just that, but it was like our first big collab type moment, so it was like, what, this is happening? Frontliner. But no, not only that, like, we also got to create a pretty cool friendship out of it, and like, then eventually joined his label.
Yep.
So no, it was like a really awesome opportunity, and I think we seized it and made the most of it. And
what's your thoughts on Frontliner with hair now?
yeah. No, but have you seen his photos without hair, like, recently?
No.
Like, now I see his photos without hair, and I think that looks more not right.
Really?
Yeah.
Oh, I still can't wrap my head around it. It does my head. What would you say, like, at what point in Dillytek's history, at what point did you go, like, I think this is actually going to turn into something, like, this could be our career, or?
Well, from the beginning. Like, not, like, this is before we had even done anything. It was like, no, this is what we're going to do.
Yep.
But as far as milestones, I don't know, I guess like getting on some of the tours and then signing with Keep It Up, and going back even just to recent, like, you get goals in like your DJ career, things that you accomplish, and they kind of just like more reiterate kind of where you're going.
It's an ever evolving tour,
I
imagine.
Yeah, definitely.
I think, right, for Luke and I, when we first started this show or come up with the idea of this show, I think we had the same things, like, we're going to make something of this. And now I hope we do.
And then you actually make the accomplishment and it's like, oh shit, this is working. This is happening.
It's been a scary week. Yeah.
So you recently signed with Dirty Works?
Yeah, that's correct.
You got one of those sexy Dirty Works jackets?
No, not yet.
Oh, not yet?
Yeah, I'm sure they're in the mail.
So how big of a deal is that for you?
Oh, it's huge.
Yeah?
Yeah, for us, like, you know, to be up on there and be on, like, a part of the Dirty Works team, and, like, there's so many guys on that label that we look up to. And, you know, to feel a part of that, you know, it's really, really awesome. So, no, we're over the moon with it.
That's awesome.
Every time you hear or say the word awesome...
I was just...
does it sound like you're plugging your latest track? Because we're going to talk about that in a second.
No, it's actually, like, whenever we've been talking about the track, and we'll be, like, going back and forth, whether it would be with the person who did the animation for us, or... just even talking with Tilsy and be like, yeah, that's pretty awesome. I was like, oh shit, you gotta find new words. Like,
well, before we give away too much about the track, how about we have a listen to it and a watch of the film clip, and then we'll have a chat about that after this little This Is Awesome by Dillytek.
Now everybody stand up real quick. Stand up. All you gotta do, put one hand in the air, turn it around, make a little claw like you're holding a hand mirror, bend it off at your arm, lean into it, and when you see how powerful and beauty and mighty you are, you gotta say the words, I am Now everybody stand up real quick. Stand up. All you gotta do, put one hand in the air, turn it around, make a little claw like you're holding a hand mirror, bend it off at your arm, lean into it, and when you see how powerful and beauty and mighty you are, you gotta say the words, I am
That was cool.
Yeah, sick. So Aaron, I just wanted to ask you, with that film clip, who did it and how did they do it?
Yeah, so Meg Bryson, she's a film and animation producer out of Sydney. She's done work previously for The Strangers and Tone Shifters. And so, like, Tilsy and I came up with a little bit of a concept for, like, I don't know, the I Am Awesome thing. We thought might be cool for a bit of a comic thing, superhero type thing, and we knew that she had done work for those guys who we're good friends with, and so we thought we'd hit her up, and then yeah, it pretty much came out of that. She came over to my house one day, took a bunch of photos of us, storyboarded some stuff, and yeah, went really well. I think we're really happy with the outcome.
Yeah, it's awesome.
It was pretty well. We're not going to be able to say awesome for the whole rest of the show.
It's really good.
That was really well received at DEF CON too, wasn't it?
Yeah, I think so. Everyone was kind of like acting out the motions a little bit, which we're trying to invoke a little bit.
Like, I was thinking the other day I was going to come on the show and like and act it all out, but I didn't. I've been busy writing the show. Oh yeah, I just wanted to ask if I can. I'm gonna fix this little graphic up, just because we can. Right behind Aaron right now is the very first picture you guys put up on your Facebook page. You might need to move to your right a little bit. No, your other right. That dude on the right of your screen is Aaron unshaven.
Shaven.
I mean shaven rather, yeah, without the beard.
Who is that guy?
You don't even look like the same person. Put in the comments, we're going to do a bit of a vote. Put in the comment section below if you think he should shave it off or shouldn't shave it off.
Live on the show.
We'll do it live during the set.
Did you bring a razor?
you don't really have to, we're not really going to, but it'd be interesting to see what people say. I just found that and had to bring it up because... I didn't even know who it was. I'm like,
cool. Baby face, man.
Have I just booked the right person for the show? So the awesome track, like, tell us how that all sort of, not just the film clip, but the track itself, how that all came about.
Yeah. I just basically just started out with a riff. Wanted to do something a little bit funky, with some chords. I don't know, try and show off like some ear candy a little bit. And then we wanted to do something, I don't know, that was a little bit tough and drivey, but still had that euphoric kind of feel to it. So, which is what we're about, you know, wanting those euphoric feels, but still got drive and still got a hard edge. And I think we achieved it.
I think I give it 2 thumbs up. Luke?
I would cut people's thumbs off to give it more thumbs up.
That's pretty brutal.
That's the best compliment we've ever had.
That's very hard style of you, Luke. By the way, I think Luke's put in the comment section below to the where you can purchase that track if you wanted to. Yep. We put the Beatport track up, link. Is that the right?
Yeah, that one or hardstyle.com.
Yeah. I wasn't sure which one to go with, and I probably could have asked you, but I didn't.
Just appreciate the share, thanks.
So Aaron, you're going to stick around. You're going to play a mix for us later on. Is that right?
Yep. Got a few exclusives too, so looking forward to it.
Look out. So you can follow Aaron's career by liking the Dillytek Facebook page, and I'll put the link in the comments now.
After the break, we will return with the Unhinged gig guide. We might do Kaze's DJ tip if time permits. We'll also decide, or we'll find out after the break too, if Aaron's going to shave his beard off. We'll give away a DEF CON jacket, which is right behind me, by the way. We're going to give away this... Ooh, I should probably talk to the microphone. We're going to give this jacket away a little bit later on in the show. And, of course, we're going to have a chat with the man behind the Slendy show, Harrison Cox.